Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, the icing on the What's My Line cake, Soupy Sales.
It's a pleasure. Welcome back, our panelists. Beautiful young lady who comes from a beautiful show business family, very talented. Would you please welcome Lucie Arnaz? Yes.
When you play on a panel like What's My Line, it's easy to learn if you sit next to a man named Gene Rayburn.
That's very kind of you to say that. I was about to say, every time I sit in this chair, I get the smarts. That's because I'm sitting next to the world's best at this game, Arlene Francis. Yeah.
Yeah. True, true, true.
Thank you. And now one of the very nicest people in our business, Larry Blyden.
Hello, all bodies. Welcome to Tuesday.
Nice person.
Listen, we have great challengers today, a fantastic mystery guest. You're going to have a good time.
You so always excited. Say that.
Would I lie?
I'll be the judge of that.
All right, just to show you, would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Arnold Albers. Where are you from?
I'm from Tulare, California.
Tulare, California. Okay, panel. Arnold Albers manufactures and sells an unusual piece of farm equipment. We will now show the audience what that equipment is. And just because she's from California, too, let's start with Lucie Arnaz.
Whatever you were doing with that farm equipment gave you a wonderful tan, sir.
Thank you.
Yes. Does this farm equipment, is it mechanical? Does it run by a motor?
Yes.
It does. And to use this piece of equipment, do you have to sit in it?
No.
One down and nine to go, Gene.
It wasn't really a no, right?
So it's powered by an engine, a gasoline engine or something like that, or an electric motor. And but you don't drive this thing.
That's correct.
No.
And does this do something with a crop?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Arlene.
Does it do anything with an animal?
Yes.
Does it do anything with a cow?
Yes.
Does it an automatic milker?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Soupy.
No, please.
But it's please. And it's with a cow?
Yeah.
Be careful now.
Does it kiss it or something?
Wait a minute. This is something with a cow.
Be serious.
Okay, be serious. Okay, now, when it does something with this cow.
Yes. Does it like the cow?
Let me ruin it
I'm
my
sorry.
Own.
Okay, shape up.
Oh, shape up. Okay, now. It's something with a cow. Does it, is it a cow wash?
It yes. is an automatic cow wash. Oh. I tell you, Arnold, since nobody likes a wise guy, we'll throw him all over anyway.
That's terrible.
And I'd like to Arnold throw Albers in $10 of my own.
Arnold Albers is vice president of Albers Manufacturing Company, Inc., inventors and manufacturers of the automatic cow wash.
Cow wash?
Why do you have a cow wash at all?
In California, it's state law that cows have to be washed twice a day in order to produce the clean milk, which we do have in California.
I see, along with the sunshine and all.
Along with the sunshine.
All right, well, now, Arnold has brought along some film of the cow wash in action, so let's have a look at it now. Lloyd, could we roll the film and see how it works? That's a chute, is it?
Oh, I love it. Hot wax!
Are those jets of water there?
Yes, those are the banks of sprays that the cows go through.
Do they like it?
They love it after they get used to it.
How does a cow get dirty?
What kind of cow around?
Those are the Holstein Friesian breed, which is most popular in the West.
Beautiful.
Look at it.
Do you air dry them?
No, the California sunshine usually dries them off pretty good.
Did you notice that they're
those are machine washed, God dried cows. Like
look at that.
You didn't wash behind the ears.
Now, you see, wasn't that fun?
Yeah.
You think
I wanted
that was
to ask if you got...
if you got what?
That's terrible. A free wash with 10 gallons of milk. It's a California joke. You
would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Emily Howell. Where are you from, Miss Howell?
Aurora, Colorado.
Aurora, Colorado. God, it's such a beautiful state. Ah, panel, Emily Howell is the first and only woman in the United States to hold a job like hers. She provides a service, and we will now show the audience what her line is. And let's start the game with Gene Rayburn.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Larry. So you're Emily Howell. and you do this oddball thing. Could you do this in any other state other than Colorado?
Yes.
And do both men and women avail themselves of this service?
Yes.
And when the service is performed, is it necessary for the person to go to you?
Yes.
And when you do it, do you come in contact with the person's body in any way, shape, or form, or manner?
There's an aspect of that, Gene, but it isn't central to the function, really. One down and nine to go, Arlene.
Do you move around in your job at all?
Yes.
Are you in some kind of a vehicle of some sort?
Yes.
And you're the only woman that does this?
Yes.
Is the vehicle ever off the ground?
Yes.
Are you in some kind of plane?
Yes.
The only woman that... Are you a pilot?
Yes.
What kind?
Are you the... What kind of a pilot? I hope she's a good one.
That's what we're after. It's what makes it so unique.
A commercial airline?
Yes.
What kind?
TWA? What do you mean, what kind?
No, what kind of...
What kind of a plane?
A Ford tri-motor.
No, no. a 757? 707?
747.
No, there's a name for the generic species of plane. And she's the only woman who flies it. And Jean
jet?
Has it. A jet pilot.
I didn't know there was any other.
It's a whole other thing, Arlene, to qualify as a jet pilot. It's a whole other...
Oh, I didn't know there was any other kind of plane anymore.
Well, there are other kinds, and a lot of women fly them, but Emily is employed by Frontier Airlines as a second officer aboard their Boeing 737 jet airplanes and is currently the only female jet pilot on a scheduled U.S. airline carrier. How did you get the job?
Well, I was employed by Clinton Aviation Company in Denver for 14 years as a flight instructor. And this is how I logged 7,000 hours, which qualified me for the job.
You have to have 7,000 hours
to
fly jets?
No, you just have to have a lot of flight time and ratings.
Well, do other women have that many hours of flying time?
There are several women, and the United States Air Force and Navy are starting programs now. And taking women into pilot training as of this time. So here's another way for girls to build time.
How many men are flying as jet pilots now in the world?
35,000.
And one woman?
What odds?
That's a pretty good... Where do you fly?
Frontier flies in 17 states and serves 97 communities.
How did the men react when you came in and said, I'm the new pilot here?
Well, they knew I was coming, but But they think it's great. The reaction has just been tremendous.
Boy, you're going to have a lot of fun at the convention.
Thank you very much for being with us on What's My Line. Thank you, Chet. We're back, and we have time for a fast round of Who's Who.
Hooray!
So, Lloyd, could we open the curtain, please? And here are four ladies and gentlemen who have nicely consented to play with us. One is a crop duster. How about that? A florist, an executive secretary, and a chemical engineer. All you have to do is hand out the card so that each person is holding the card that states his or her occupation. You have 20 seconds. We'll start with Lucy. Ready, set, go.
Go.
That is incorrect, and here comes Jean Rayburn.
Ta-da-da!
And that is correct.
Thank you.
And would you now tell us who you are, please?
I'm Ellen Farben, a chemical engineer from Somerville, New Jersey.
This is Richard Rod, an executive secretary from Omaha, Nebraska.
Okay. I'm Fred Pauley. I'm a florist from Pleasantville, New Jersey.
Okay.
I'm Jack Terhune from Perryton, Texas, and I'm crop duster.
Okay, gentlemen. You've won $25. We have a special gift for each of you, and thank you for playing Who's Who on What's My Line. That's terrific.
Each member of the Who's Who team will receive a Samsonite Silhouette Softie, the casual carry-on suitor featuring three compartments for efficient packing. Samsonite, we make travel a little easier.
I tell you, I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm in shock from that man from New Jersey.
Yeah.
Who said, I'm a chemical engineer and I come from New Jersey. Sent me into shock. I got to find out how come that happened that way. Listen, it's time for the appearance of our mystery guest now. So it's blindfold time, panel. Are your blindfolds all in place? Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, you have about 2 minutes. We'll go one question at a time, and let's start with Soupy Sales.
Thank you, Larry. Mystery guest, would we find your name in the entertainment sections of the paper?
Yes, you probably would.
Lucy?
would your name be associated mostly with television, sir?
Well, it was at one time, but I'm not so sure about now.
Gene?
Let's see. When you were in television, did you do a weekly situation comedy program?
No, wasn't too funny. It was weekly, though.
As opposed to poorly.
Arlene?
Was it a weekly Western?
No, honey, it wasn't. It was something else.
Uh-huh.
Soupy?
Was it a weekly detective show?
No.
Lucy?
Can I guess?
I know who
if
it
you
is.
Want to.
Are you Glen Campbell?
No, I'm not.
Oh, darn.
Gene?
I thought I
were
had.
You a classmate of Don Meredith at the University of Florida?
No.
Oh, it's not Burt Reynolds.
No.
Arlene?
I sort of wish it was, though.
You've got him completely baffled, Arlene.
Well, now, he used to have a television series.
All right.
Are you at the present time performing in either the theater or motion pictures?
Yeah.
Soupy?
Would you be performing now in the theater?
Well, I was a little bit ago, and I will be soon, but not right now.
Lucy?
It was a little bit ago.
Yeah.
About 10 seconds?
Are you a musical person? Singing
not,
and things.
Not very. I've done a little bit.
Gene?
Where'd you leave the corn pone?
This is so funny.
You
a little bit ago.
Obviously.
Well, I tell you, obviously the time is up and the
so
man has just baffled you utterly. He's a marvelous actor and his name is Richard Chamberlain.
Ah!
Oh,
no. Oh, oh, oh. So embarrassed.
That was really terrific.
I'm so embarrassed.
That was really terrific. They you fool them with that accent. They never thought a doctor, Western. They saw all kinds of things on your boots, but none of them were alcohol. And you've just made a movie with Laurence Olivier now.
And Sarah Miles. And Robert Bolt wrote it and directed it. It's a fabulous movie called Lady Caroline Lamb.
You played Lord Byron.
Lord Byron, yes.
And what aspect of Byron's life is involved?
Well, it's mainly about his affair with Lady Caroline, which really was a historical kind of scandal in England. And it's about that time. And she was a fabulous kind of social lady, and he was just making it as a poet. And he was kind of like the first pop star in a way. He'd really turned London on with his Childe Harold's pilgrimage poem. Mm-hmm.
He was a brilliant poet, but in those days you could be a big hit as a poet.
Right. Nowadays, it was like Mick Jagger, kind of. It was an incredible kind of success.
That kind of thing.
Yeah,
I hadn't realized it. Now, listen, as you go around the world, and you've been everywhere now, acting and playing Hamlet and God knows what all, do you ever run into to Dr. Kildare anywhere?
Well, it's on in funny places now, places like Warsaw and Bulgaria and Yugoslavia. I get these letters written in these strange languages.
Do they like it there?
They seem to, yeah.
Have you ever seen yourself in Polish?
No, I haven't. I tried to get them to send me one when it was in Japanese, but they never did. That'd really be funny, wouldn't it?
Are they dubbed? Are they dubbed in the...
Yeah.
How do you sound in the Japanese?
Well, sort of like that.
Dick, thank you for being with us. It's really wonderful. You really cool. We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message. And we have time for one more game, so would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Joseph Malkin.
Is it Malkin or Malkin?
Where are you from, Mr. Malkin?
North Bergen, New Jersey.
Okay, panel. Joseph Malkin is a policeman who works in a most unusual place, and we will now show the audience where it is Patrolman Malchan works. And we'll start with Arlene Francis.
You work in an unusual place, and I presume, therefore, it is not in Bergen, New Jersey.
That's correct.
Is it unusual because it is not a place that is usually policed?
No.
No.
One down and nine to go, Soupy.
Are there a lot of people there, Mr.?
At times.
Yeah. Do you, in this job, do you work for a profit-making organization?
Yes, I would say so.
Do you...
It might mislead you, Soupy. It may very well be, but the likelihood of our thinking of it in that way is pretty remote. So in order to clear your mind, let's have a two down and eight to go, Lucy.
This place that you patrol, is it inhabited by both men and women?
This is peopled by both, isn't it?
Does he patrol?
Yes.
He said he's a
three
patrol.
Down seven. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yes.
It? Yes. Yeah,
and am I right in assuming that because Soupy, you patrol this or you... No, wait, you patrol this place, you don't work there, is that correct? I mean, you are a policeman there for protection?
Yes, he's there as a policeman.
As a policeman.
I thought it was an extra job.
No, that's his job.
No, you are there as a policeman, correct.
Right.
And, and you said it was inhabited by both, men and women.
He didn't say it was inhabited, he said it was peopled.
Well, I mean, peopled, oh, well. Would children come to this place as well?
They can.
They can. You don't have to be a certain age, then, is that correct?
No.
That's right. does it have anything to do with show business in any way, this type of place?
No.
Three down, seven to go, Gene.
You pack a rod?
Oh, yes.
Is it likely that you would ever have to use it?
Yes, we could.
Are the people who are there, are they restrained, or can they come and go freely? Are they restrained?
No.
They're not restrained.
No, they can come and go freely. Four down and six to go, Arlene.
Is it a place out of doors?
No.
Five down and five to go, Soupy.
And you patrol this and it's indoors. Is it a, do people, are they already there or do people come to this place?
They usually come.
To the place.
I tell you, we're out of time, and it's a shame, because we're sort of at the end. You have a quick thing?
What do you think? Grounds.
Hmm?
Picnic grounds.
Picnic grounds? No, try undergrounds. The Lincoln Tunnel.
The Lincoln Tunnel.
The Lincoln Tunnel, for people who are not from New York and don't know, goes under the Hudson River and it joins New York and New Jersey. How many years have you worked there?
About 16 and a half years.
Well, that's a long time.
How's the air pollution?
How many hours at a time do you stay in the tunnel?
Well, we usually do 4 hours a day, two in and two out.
Now, is that because of the quality of the air down there?
Not necessarily.
The monotony.
Right, to break the monotony.
Yeah.
It gets you, huh?
It does, after a while.
How do you patrol down there?
Well, right now we have a catwalk car, which makes us move a lot faster in a tunnel. In other words, anything unusual happens, we can get to the scene much faster.
How long does it take to get out? How long does it take to get out if a car is stuck there?
Well, usually it takes about 6 minutes and you're out.
Do you ever arrest anybody for making a U-turn?
We gotta go. Goodbye, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.
This is Chet Gould speaking for What's My Line, a Mark Goodson, Bill Taubman production. Miss Frances Gowns by Bonwit Teller. This program was recorded.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on.
Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's going to be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on. Push the button.
Please subscribe. Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.